Bitcoin, the very first cryptocurrency to be created, was launched in January of 2009 to be an alternative to traditional currencies. Alternative in the sense that it should be able to serve as a means of exchange like traditional currencies, but without the same territorial control or restrictions. The creator of Bitcoin, who goes by the alias Satoshi Nakamoto, came into the limelight when they dropped the Bitcoin white paper on October 31st, 2008. Bitcoin has been around long enough that it has paved the way for other cryptos. A lot of the recognition and acceptance that crypto currently enjoys from regular people and government bodies alike can be traced back to Bitcoin. Granted, there still aren't many countries that have legalized Bitcoin as a medium of exchange, and it also isn't formally recognized as a store of value, but it has managed to exist and, dare we say, even thrive in the financial system since its creation, something that a lot of cryptocurrencies cannot boast of. Secondly, Bitcoin is one of the very few cryptocurrencies with a limited supply. There are only 21 million bitcoins available to be mined, which is very small compared to other cryptos with a limited supply. But actually, there are even less bitcoins than that. Maybe you have heard of James Howells before, who mined about 7,500 bitcoin using his gaming computer in 2009, only to discard the hard drive storing his private keys while cleaning his home office. That trove, worth today more than $320 million, is likely sitting in a dump in Newport, Wales. As you can imagine, James Howells isn't the only one who lost some bitcoins. Data analytics firm Chain Analysis estimates that about a fifth of all coins mined to date, somewhere between 2 and 4 million, are lost forever. Now, simple economics teaches that scarcity results in an increase in value. And that was exactly the intent when Satoshi Nakamoto patched the supply at 21 million. And because of this limited supply, some financial experts are beginning to consider Bitcoin as a great option to hedge against inflation. If you are more interested in that topic, we have a video on this channel where we talk about crypto as an inflation hedge, so you might want to check that out. I will link it for you here. But the summary is that because there is a limited number of bitcoins that can be mined, neither the government nor even the Bitcoin development team can mine more and push it into the economy, meaning there cannot be a Bitcoin inflation. So following a logical sequence, it would mean that regardless of the rise or fall in the value of fiat money, Bitcoin should be able to maintain its value and thus even grow its value measured in inflating fiat currencies. In that sense, it is very similar to gold and other precious metals. A counter-argument some financial experts like to bring about calling Bitcoin a great inflation hedge is the volatility of the market. But the only reason, or the major reason, Bitcoin and other cryptocurrencies are so volatile is because of their relative newness. Granted, Bitcoin has been in the financial space for about 12 years now, but that is almost insignificant compared to other financial tools and currencies. So if the problem of volatility gets resolved with crypto's continued existence in the market, Bitcoin would make the best inflation hedge of all the cryptos currently in existence. And to emphasize how limited in supply Bitcoin is, 18 million of the total 21 million Bitcoins have already been mined. Right now, Bitcoin has a market cap of about $800 billion. Accounting for about half of the total cryptocurrency market cap. So, the coin is doing really well. That said, while Bitcoin is the OG crypto and has the highest market cap of all cryptocurrencies in the market, it has a number of significant shortcomings. For one, validating transactions on the Bitcoin blockchain takes a way longer time than with other cryptocurrencies. And in addition to that, mining Bitcoin isn't the best for the environment, as it requires a lot of electricity. Sadly, transaction fees are also comparatively high. Anyone can mine Bitcoin, so you can too if you want to. If you are unfamiliar with mining, basically, mining Bitcoin is about solving some complex mathematical equations and getting rewarded in Bitcoins. But luckily, it's not you that has to solve these problems. A software will do the job, but it requires some powerful hardware too. There are plenty of hardware that you can use to mine Bitcoin, but specific computer chips like ASICs or GPUs offer great rewards. If you build a collection of these hardware components, we are talking about a so-called mining rig. Finally, Bitcoin might not be where the creator set out for it to be in regards to acceptance and adoption, but there is no denying the fact that it is on its way there. A lot of stores now accept Bitcoin as a means of payment. The coin is listed on many payment platforms as a payment option, and in June 2021, El Salvador officially adopted it as a legal tender. So there might still be a long way to go for the coin, but it has also come a long way. If you enjoyed this video, consider leaving a like, hitting the subscribe button for more videos like this, and hitting the notification bell so that you don't miss an upload. Thanks for supporting our channel, and see you in the next one.